So let's talk a little bit about the Monty Hall problem. So this has become a very famous problem because it's actually quite an unintuitive one. So it's based on the game show Let's Make a Deal, which was hosted by Monty Hall. And here's how the game worked. The game would start with three different doors, and behind the doors were a prize. One door had a prize that you'd want to win, which I've drawn as a car here. You might not actually want to win the car that I've drawn, but let's assume that's what you want. And there were two gag prizes, and I've drawn those as goats here. So the way it works is you would pick a door. So I'm going to have Andrew here choose which door he wants. Door number one, two, or three?
Let's go with door number two.
Door number two is the choice. Okay, so then the way the game would work is the host would reveal what's behind one of the other doors, not the door that was chosen by Andrew. And a key piece of info is that the host knows where the prize is, and he's not going to reveal it and take it out of play, because that would make a pretty boring show. So I'll open up door number one here, and we can see it's the gag prize. Okay. Then the host asks, would you like to stay with your original choice, or would you like to switch to the other door? Whatever door you get, you win what's behind that door. So, Andrew, do you want to stay with your original choice, or do you want to switch?
I mean, it's the same thing, right? Let's just keep in the middle.
Let's keep it. Okay. So you get what's behind your original choice. Ding, 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 ding. You win the prize, the car. Okay. So that's the way the game works. Now, the key question here is, what's the optimal strategy to play? Should you always stay with your original choice? Should you always switch? Or does it not really matter? 50-50, your choice, go with your heart. I suggest you take a moment to pause, think about it, come up with your answer, and then following the pause, I'll go through a detailed non-mathematical explanation of showing you which is the best choice. Welcome back. So, unless you know the answer to this problem already, I'm guessing that you likely chose it doesn't really matter. One prize, two doors, 50-50, right? Wrong. The optimal strategy is actually switching, okay? And I'm going to show you why. I'm going to lay out the different possible scenarios and show you how we get to switching as being the optimal strategy. So let me just lay something out here for you. So we've said that the optimal strategy is to always switch no matter what. And I'm going to lay that out for you here, why that is. Again, with a non-mathematical, not dealing with conditional probabilities and these sorts of things, but something visual. So here what I've labeled is door one, door number two, door three, and possibility one, two, or three. Okay, so the first possibility is that the prize is behind door number one. And I'll just put little X's here to indicate those are not what you want. Or the prize is behind door number two. Or the prize is behind door number three. Right, so these are all the possibilities, and we're going to assume that the prize is equally likely to be behind door number one, door number two, or door number three. Okay, it doesn't need to be, but this is going to simplify things, and this is the reality. If it was behind a certain door more often, people would pick up on that, and it would ruin the show. Now, let's also assume that your choice was door number one. Again, it doesn't matter. We can repeat this for any door that you've chosen, but let's start with that. Okay, so what's going to happen in possibility one? You've chosen door number one. Then as the host, I can open door number two or door number three, right? I'm going to reveal an empty door. Let's just suppose that door number two is what I open for you. What's going to happen when you switch over to door number three? You're going to lose. Now let's think about possibility number two. Right again, don't forget, your choice was door number one. Now as the host, I have door number two or three available. I cannot open door number two, right, because that's going to take the prize out of play and it's going to ruin the game. So what I'm going to do is open door number three. If you switch, you're going to switch to door number two and you're going to end up winning. Now let's think of the third possibility, if the prize is behind door number three. Again, your choice has been door number one. Now as the host, they can open up door number two or three, right? But they actually can't open door number three. That's going to reveal the prize and take it out of play, which they're not going to do. So they open door number two. by switching, you switch over to door number, getting what's behind door number 3, and you win. So you can see here, by playing the switch strategy, the probability that you win is 2/3. Now, I won't get into doing this here, but you can repeat this and see what happens if you were to play the stay strategy. Right? Again, you'd see if you chose door number 1, you'll end up winning, losing, or losing. You're going to lose 2/3 of the time, right? Win only 1/3 of the time by staying with the original choice. So why was this game show so successful? Well, because they were able to play on people's psychology, right? They knew that people are going to stay with their original choice more often than switching. And if you think about it, think, you know, what would hurt yourself, or, you know, what would feel worse? If you stuck with your original choice and ended up losing, or if you switched to the other door and then ended up losing? I know, speaking for myself, if I switched and then saw the prizes behind my original choice, I think, oh man, why did I switch? I had it and I decided, you know, I doubted myself and changed. Where if you stuck with the original choice and lost, it's a lot easier to deal with a loss when it was what you chose and you didn't second guess yourself. So that's the problem. Not very intuitive, but by switching, you're going to win 2/3 of the time.
Hope you guys liked the video. Stick around, guys, because we got lots more. Statistics is so much fun.